Hi, now I am going to explain about the Frida 306 secondary injection relay testing kit. So we will see this operation of Frida and what are the functions are there, what are the parameters are there, how can we use this kit, we will see briefly. So I inform you so many videos about the safety procedure. Any testing equipments we are going to handling, we should connected the earthing properly. So I already connected the equipment earthing. So this is the safety precaution. So earthing is must for all the testing equipment, and we have to follow all the safety and regulations. So this one is Frida 306. I will tell you all the parameters one by one. This one binary inputs. This binary inputs, we are taking the status of relays. It is closed position or open position. We can get the inputs from the relay to Frida kit. This one binary outputs. So this one we take outputs for the auto reclosing purpose. We are using this binary outputs. This analog inputs. And this is the transducer. When we are going to test any transducer, we can use this probe. And this one DC supply. If we require the separate auxiliary DC supply, so we can use this DC supply. This one 20 volt to 220 volt available. So this one separate DC supply. If you want to give your relay separate DC supply, we can take from here. Then U reference. This also the like auxiliary voltage. So like here we can take AC voltage here up to 230 voltage. So this one is voltage output and current output. This one toggle switch. This toggle only we can rotate here, we can change the value. Just press in the center, just press gently. We can select the, we can enter the value. So we will see here. This one 1 to 7. It means here have 7 pages. Okay. So we will see one by one. So first page frequency is available. This one is voltage angle, current angle. Okay. So first page we are using mostly for testing the meters. So in the first page we will not get the timing for closing time, tripping time. We cannot get any timing. So this first page probably we are using for metering purpose. So how we can set the value in the first page, I will tell you. So you just rotate this knob. When you rotate, you see the cursor is moving. You see now cursor coming here. So I want change the voltage. Just press this cursor, it is changing into arrow. So you can rotate here. You can rotate here.
Anyway, I know how to hear. If you want to do. I know where you need.
So you change the voltage here. Okay, if you want change the voltage, you can change the voltage. Then press enter, the cursor will come like that. So you can go another option. If you, we can change one single phase voltage or three phase voltage at a time. So how we can change this one, I will tell you. So just rotate here and put here cursor. This one U voltage 1 2 3, current 1 2 3. So it means at a time we can, when we put this option, we can change all the phase voltage at a time. You see, any one phase you put here in cursor and press, just to change the voltage. You see, if you change one phase voltage, all three phase changing. Okay, so this one is at a time we can change all three phase. Now how we can change single phase voltage only, just press and bring it to here, then press here, then change. This one none value. None value means only one face only we can change at a time. Okay. Then you bring here. Press. You check only 1 volt only we can change. Another 2 phase it will not change the value. Okay. Then press. Now we required to change the current. Current, how can we change at a time all the phases? Then press here. I1, I2, I3. So it means we can change the currents equally. Press here, bring it to current. Now I am going to change the R phase, L1. So L1 means it will change all the L1, L2, L3, all changing. It means we are selecting all the phases at a time. So how we can change only one phase? It means L1 only I want to change the current. How can change? Enter. Then go here. Now we will bring here. So arrow, just press here. Press means this arrow will change. Then rotate.
No.
Now none. Enter. Then you bring to current. Now we select only one phase. So these two lines will not change. Okay. So press. I change the current value. So one phase only. Then enter. So now we change voltage and current. How we change the current angle and voltage angle? Then we will bring to here back. This option is voltage and current. And this one is voltage angle and current angle. If you want change at a time voltage and current angle, you and I, we can change this one. If you want change only voltage angle, then you bring here, press. None means we can change one by one from line 1, line 2, line 3. If you want to change all the phases angle, you just select this one. All the phases it will change when you select this one. Current angle, you press here. So how we change? Now I select here, then I come to current angle. So I am going to change here current angle. You see, if I change L2 angle, then all angles it's changing automatically. Okay, so this is the first menu. Page number 1. Okay. Page number 1. Okay. This one, this page is for metering. But when we are going to test the relay, we need a relay pickup time and tripping time. We need to calculate the exact timing. So we are going to move for second page. So the first one is page 1, and if you press page 2, the last one is escape. If you go 7, 6 like this, the first button is moving the page, this one escape. Then 2 start the test. For 3 I will tell you later. Okay, so now we are going to second page. So first page and second page both are same, but the only difference is we can measure here the timing. Okay, so this one is binary input contacts. So this is the binary inputs. So we need here closing contact or open contact. Normally open contact, normally closing contact. Which one we required, we can select here. The star means it is normally open. So here like 0, it is normally close. This contact is normally close, and this contact is normally open. Okay, so now how we change this star? If we want normally close to open, open to close, press here and bring it here. So this one normally close, this one none. Okay, so we put here. Now before we saw same like that page 1, here difference is the timing. So now I am going to inject the voltage. When I inject the voltage, after the binary inputs change the status means, then the injection will automatically stop. It means when the relay will trip or relay will close, the contact will be closed. Okay. When contact will close, the relay kit will stop injection automatically. So after that, here the timing is, we will measure here the timing. So this is the tripping time or pickup time. So whatever you want to measure, you can measure here. So just I'm going to inject the voltage in page 2 for relay. So now already injection started. So 7.1 we are injecting the voltage. So already we are not connected anything here. So that's why a kit is not getting stopped. If the voltage is injection as per setting, a kit will stop the injection automatically and time will come here. Okay, so this is page 2. And page 3, sequence. Sequence means this sequence we are using for when we are going to test the under voltage and under frequency. So when we are testing the under voltage protection, so this one cycle we will use 399. So second cycle is, suppose our under voltage tripping time is 0.5 seconds or 5 seconds. So 5 seconds means per cycle 60 per second 60 cycles. So 5 seconds means 300 cycles. So when we are testing the under voltage, we have to put the value more than the cycles. So 5 seconds means 300, so we kept here 400 cycles. Okay, this is the page 3. Then page 4, this is ramp up. We are going step by step ramp up testing ramp. So this one is in page 1, page 2, which voltage we required, either DC we required or AC required, we can select from this page. This is the reference voltage. For example, this back, so I want this reference voltage. This is the reference voltage, this voltage. I want this one DC voltage and I want this one AC DC voltage. So how can we change here? Actually this one is AC voltage and reference voltage also AC voltage. All we are going to bring into a DC. So how can we change this one? So for that one we have to go page number 5. Okay, here we can change the DC or whatever we need. So just bring it here, press here. This is the DC voltage, or we don't require the reference voltage, we can off here. Okay, all option is here. So we need reference voltage DC, we need injection voltage also DC. So how can we change? Just go here, press, then change the voltage. We don't want here DC, but the line 3 I don't want voltage, so just make it off. So then we will go to first page, we will see there I change the voltage everything. Now we are going to see the first one. So I already the line 3 I make off there in page 5, right? So here not showing the line 3 voltage. Here line 1, line 2, both are DC voltage because I selected the DC, and reference voltage also I selected DC. Okay, so I am going to the page number 5. Okay, then press, put AC, then reference voltage AC, sorry, AC, then this one AC, then AC. So now we will go to the first page. So I already put L1, L2 and L3 is still DC. So we have to bring the AC. So this one still AC. Okay, now L3 also AC. Huh? of all voltage AC with phase angle. Okay, so this is the we completed now all the 7 pages. Okay, this one before I told you, this is the transducer. When we are going to voltage transducer, current transducer, we are going to testing, that time we are using this probe and page number 6. So page number 6 is frequency, sorry, page number 7 is frequency. So we are going to change all three phases frequency. We can select here and we can change current phase, current we can change here frequency. Then in the page number 2, how can we change the frequency? I will tell you. This we bring here, this one to frequency. Frequency, just press here and rotate. What is your system frequency? You can select here 50 or 60. My system frequency is 60, so I selected here 60. Okay, so this probe first for voltage injection only. I will show you just reference. I am going to measure the phase 1 voltage. Injection voltage. Okay, I connected here clammeter. So this is the multimeter I connected here. So I am going to measure this voltage. Now page number 2. Voltage, I am going to change the voltage. We are voltage R phase, I put 50 voltage. Okay, 55 voltage, enter. Now we are going to inject the voltage. It means we are going to start the test for voltage injection. Okay, so I am going to start the voltage. So what is the voltage here? We can measure in the meter without timing, because we did not connect the relay. Okay, test is started. So we measure here voltage 54.9. so we are injection voltage is 55. Okay, already injection is started and injection is going on. So we get the voltage here, how much? 54.9. so stop the injection. Then we will change this connection to L3. now we will measure how much voltage in L3 for injection. So we will change here little L3 voltage. We put 100 voltage. Okay, 100 okay, 100.8. so L3 we are going to measure. Okay, I connected this one L3. So now we are going to measure the L3 voltage. Start the injection. My injection voltage is from the relay kit 100.8. measuring voltage 100.6. it means almost correct. So this page is we measure for relay, and page 1 for metering. So now we are checking our kit is working normal, there is no problem. So if we want to check in relay, we don't have actually now relay. We are going to test in the field, then we will show in the we will see in the field. Okay, thank you for your cooperation. And
yeah, okay.